Diabetes currently affects over 20 million adults in the United States alone, and an additional 60 million are thought to be at risk for the development of type 2 diabetes. We found a relay system that has an important effect on the production of glucose by the liver, and it could be useful in the treatment of insulin resistance. There are a number of complications that are associated with diabetes. Most of these are thought to be due to the high glucose that's in the bloodstream. And these complications include heart disease, kidney failure, loss of limbs, and blindness, among others. A number of drugs on the market that are useful in the treatment, for example, metformin or glucophage is very widely used and is somewhat effective, especially in early cases of type 2 diabetes, but then people can often become more insulin resistant. And so finding other ways of treating high glucose levels would have beneficial effects. Normally, the production of glucose is regulated by genetic switches, one of which that we've been interested in is called CRTC2. What makes this relay system worth studying, we think, is that the activity of the IP3 receptor spigot and the calcineurin accelerator are both increased in diabetic animals. And if we reduce the activities of the spigot and the accelerator, we can shut down the production of glucose and make these animals more, what we would say, have normal blood glucose levels. So we think that's going to be important because these are proteins in the cells that may be amenable to development of drugs and could be useful for the treatment of individuals with type 2 diabetes.